Hey there,
People,
my name's George. That's me. Anyways, some of you may be wondering what is going on. Well, I decided to retire from the orchard. You'd be wondering why so early in life? Well, orchard life is not what it used to be honest. Years ago when I took over the farm from my parents in 1996, and even then it wasn't that good. The only way to make money in this business is to have customers, private customers that go from orchard direct, or you have a couple of middle people. You have a customer buys off you, you're the farmer, buys off you, and then he sells to the store. Or you have a truck and you do marketing and you go from your farm to the store. That's the only way you make money in the orchard business. I don't know about farming and such. I don't know much about farming stuff. It's not my experience. I'm talking about orchard life. I've told people over the years, better for you to get an education, get a trade, something else, and steer clear from orchard life, because you don't make any money. I mean, my generation, I mean, you know, people that are getting around 50 years old, I mean, either you make it or you break it. Or you decide to toss in the towel, sell, and get the hell out of Dodge. And that's what I've done. I did it for financial reasons too. Farming is not what it used to be. And it's hard to make money. Could I do it for another 30 years? Maybe. Maybe not. There's too much politics in the farm, in the orchard lifestyle. There's too many people with their hands in the pot stealing from you. And it's just the laws and regulations are getting to be crazy. As you guys know, with the way the world's going, they want you regulated and certified for every damn thing, like every damn thing possible. So when you're in the orchard business, you think, oh, well, I'm going to grow fruit and I'm going to sell it and you're going to be hunky-dory. Well, it doesn't work that way. As being you're growing food, there's regulations. You have to be, there's many regulations, I'm going to name a few. You have canned gap certification. You have food safe certification, different from food safe, which you would see in a restaurant. Different kind of certification. This deals with growing fruits and handling of fruits and workers and such. Whole different ballgame. Then you have pesticide applicator ticket, and then there's everything else in between. When you have food safe certification, and if you have people working for you, there's a heap load of paperwork, and you have to be on top of it, because if you're not, when the inspectors come twice a year to your property, depending on how many people you have working for you, they nitpick at you at every little thing. And if something is not up to their standards, they'll shut you down. So you can have $200,000 or $300,000 of fruit to come off your trees, and they'll shut you down. And you gotta fix it. Not, you're not shipping your fruit. And that could be if you're dealing with a private packer or a corporate packer or whatever it is. If the food safe inspectors don't like your fruit, your product, it's gonna come back on you, and you're gonna be in deep caca. The other thing is you need to have crop insurance. The crop insurance will protect you if something goes sideways in your fruit business. You can have years where you can have lots of rain, you can have hail, you can have heat. There's so many things. You can have, sometimes you may get a chemical that was not that was a defective chemical, and it causes your whole crop to to burn out or cause damage to your fruit crop, well, your crop insurance will pick up on that. So, the years we have a lot of, if you have cherries, you have years that it rains lots, all your cherries split. Well, any crop insurance. If you have one piece of fruit that has brown rot in it or SWD, cherry fruit fly, you have the SWD and cherry fruit fly, the spotted wing Drosophila, and the cherry fruit fly, the two bad ones. There might be another one now, and they're now too, but who knows? I'm not in the cherry business. All these things are factors, and you deal with a cooperative packing house and a private packing house, you'd have all your ducks in a row. Everything has to be perfect, perfect, perfect. And if you're just a guy who wants to grow fruit and make money, you gotta follow the rules. For me, I wanna grow fruit, but not deal with the bullshit. And I got tired of it. I was a small operation, and you can't justify, I can't be sitting behind a desk doing paperwork. I wanna be out there out in the orchard, growing, thinning the fruits and, spraying it and mowing it and maintaining it. I don't want to be behind a desk doing paperwork. I'm not interested. I don't want to be hiring people. I do enough bullshit at work as it is with employees. I don't need to be dealing with it at home, And the other thing too, when you're in the orchard business, you have to be big enough. It's all about volume. You cannot be a hobby farm. We can be a hobby farm and make money, but you're small scale, and if you're just doing it to put extra money in your pocket or keep your property taxes down, that's one thing. But if you're in it to make $100,000, $200,000, $300,000, $500,000, whatever it is, you need to have acreage. You need to have 100, 200, 300 acres. Between 50 and 100, you can do it. You can, between 50 and 100 acres. Well, okay, let's go a little bit more reasonable. Between 25 and 50 acres, you can make it. Okay. But you're going to have a lot of expenses. Okay. Then you got to worry about labor. You want more land, more labor, more fuel, more chemicals. So, you get a pesticide applicator ticket. Buy those chemicals and apply it on your orchard, and there again, it's paperwork, paperwork, paperwork. Something else I hated, and I still have to do it with my little hobby farm. I still have to follow those rules, but not to the extent of shipping to a private and corporate packer. So there's many factors you gotta think about, and then food safe gets sticky. They want to know about your workers. You want to know their cleanliness habits. They want to know their health habits. You want to know their health. If they have some kind of disease or they're sick or who knows what. They don't want that. And that's more cost. It's more insurance for the farmer, for the owner. There's so many factors. And, more acreage, more headache, and that's the way it goes. There's nothing in between. It's just all up in the air, and it's just the way it is. You want to make more money, you gotta spend more money. So what happens is, after all your expenses, after you pay all your wages, which nowadays here, your wages are $15 an hour minimum wage. You have a lot of acreage, you're paying a lot of money for acreage to get that fruit. All your orchard maintained. It hurts your bottom line. So after your accountant deducts all the labor, all the chemicals, all the fuel, other maintenance, you're probably still walking away with $200,000 in your pocket. If that. If. Depends on the climate, too. You get a bad year, you know, you may only make between $50,000 and $100,000, and then you're in the red. So, I retired from Orchard Business because it's just too much bullshit. There's too many politics in the business, and I don't want to do it anymore. And I'm a one-man show, small little acreage, and I can't do it. I mean, I got no family, and I can't afford to pay people to help me. And I don't, you know, it's just not my way. I mean, you know, I'm just tired of it. And that's one of the reasons I quit. I'm just tired of the BS in the politics. So, food for thought for people who watch my video, if you're in the Okanagan area of British Columbia, I mean, there's not too many white farmers anymore. Most of them are of Punjabi culture, and they're taking over everything. That's fine dandy, but even if you are Punjabi, Sikh, Hindu, whatever you are from that culture, think twice about what you're doing getting into this business, because it's not pretty. You can make it or break it. You're better off to go to school, get education, and, you know, be a lawyer, doctor, if you have the education, do something else. You make way more money doing that. Sure, farming is a nice lifestyle, and you have freedom and such. You don't make any money. You'll work 100 years wasting your life away in this bullshit when you could be making $100,000, $200,000 a year at your job, good paying job, whatever your trade is, whatever your education is, whatever your business is, way better than farming, you know. And the other thing too is, the other thing to think about too, orchards are becoming a thing of the past. Now here they're more or less growing grapes, and that's what they want. They want grapes. There's no future to grape business. You know, it's not something of need. It's a want. Just like tobacco, I mean, the same thing, right? It's a want. You don't need it. People need to eat fruits and vegetables. That's what's important. But it's not the way the industry is going. So it's a slippery slope to hell if that's what you want to do. But from my experience, being started in 1996, and my parents came to Canada and they worked in the orchards from late 50s till you know, the early 90s, and my mom was working in the orchard until a couple years ago. So, I mean, and most of my family too. Until a couple years ago, most of my family wasn't, before that. 5 or 6 years ago, everybody was in the orchard business. Now everyone is retired and done other things. So that's the way it's gone. And you know, for the younger generation to get into it, I would steer clear from it. I wouldn't. I just wouldn't get into it. You know, if that's what you want to do, fine. But I mean, you're better off just getting education and say the hell with it. I wouldn't bother with this business. It's just too much work, too much headache. Good for, like I said, it's good for hobby farm. We do it for a hobby, grow, you know, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10 acres, something, right? I don't care what you grow. Do it as a hobby, you know, make, you know, $50,000, whatever it is. What to do? Just don't take it seriously. Just do your job. Well, it's tough to say. I just want to put that out there. If you're, like I said, if you are thinking about getting into the orchard business, give your head a shake or stick your head in water, because it's not worth it. It's a sad note, but it's the way it is. Thanks for watching my video. If you find this information informative, give me a thumbs up. And remember to comment, like, and share my videos. Certainly also subscribe. And if you have any more questions about regarding orchard business and other things in life, other things in the orchard business, give me a comment, and I'll I'll answer it to the best of my ability. Bye for now.